So you've got some Raspberry Pi installations out there that can dual boot and so forth, but I thought I'm going to take this to the extreme. I'm going to quad boot my Raspberry Pi. Stick around to see how I did it. All right, so we're going to quad boot this Raspberry Pi with Rasbian with the Pixels desktop, Retropie, RasPlex, which is Plex, and Kodi. And you'll be able to choose what installation of Kodi you want from there as well. So let's pop over to the computer and see how this gets installed. Okay, so the first thing you're going to want to do is go to multibootpi.com. Okay, and once that loads up, you'll see straight away quad boot there. However, if it's a little bit older, this video, we've got to click on builds. Once we click on builds, we'll see quad boot there. And if you scroll down, triple boot and multi-boot. So the one we want is quad boot. So we'll click on continue reading. Now the first link there, I accidentally clicked on that and guess what? That goes nowhere. So I'll go back and scroll up and it says click here to download. So click there. Opens up a Google Drive page and click download anyway. All it's saying is that the image is over 2 gigabytes and that it's probably gonna take a while to download. So I'm gonna speed this up. Okay, and there it's finished. So it must have just been over 2 gigabytes. And now what we'll do is we will write those files to an SD memory card. Now, one thing to note is that you will require a memory card that is bigger than 8 gigabytes. So just make sure you've got that on hand. Now this quad boot install does only work on a Raspberry Pi 2 or a Raspberry Pi 3. So if you don't have a Raspberry Pi 2 or 3, unfortunately quad booting won't work for you, or this image at least. Okay, so what we'll need to do is open up the removable disk, which is the SD card, the micro SD. And I've had a quick look over the README file, which you can as well. But what we need to do is we need to copy all of these files directly onto the SD card. Now, what will happen is that once this boots on the Raspberry Pi, it will take care of the rest. So this will speed up and we'll get this finished in a sec. Okay, so that's done now. So we can eject that SD card and let's throw it in the Raspberry Pi and see how it goes. All right, so now we've got that on our micro SD card. It's time to go over to the Pi and let's see how it runs. All right, so here we are. We're booting up the installer on the Raspberry Pi. We'll speed this up just a little bit. Okay, and here we come to the installer section where we can select which operating systems we want to install. So in this case, we want to install Rasbian, RetroPie, RasPlex. Sorry, I've changed Rasbian to Rasbian MultiBoot. So we've got the four there. We've got OpenELEC, RasPlex, Rasbian, and RetroPie. And now all we need to do is click install and say yes. And now we've got a long wait. So I'll speed this up so it finishes a lot quicker. And there we go, hit okay. And now you can select what operating system you want to boot to. In our case, we'll boot through each one. So we'll first boot into OpenELEC and we'll speed this up just a little bit. Oh, no need to, there we go. So we're up to the welcome OpenELEC screen and we'll just quickly walk through the setup and we're done. So that's Kodi setup. Now you'll notice under programs, we've got the other operating systems there. So we can boot straight out of there into Rasbian. Now, of course, the Raspberry Pi does a full reboot in order to launch into Rasbian. And this is with the new Pixel desktop. And look at that. Okay, so we've got the launcher down the bottom. And that feels really, really nice. All right, and again, here's the shortcuts to the other operating system. So we'll launch into RetroPie. Okay, so we'll quickly configure the Xbox 360 controller. All right, now we're into RetroPie. And again, you can see that they're already set up there with the shortcuts of the other operating systems. So
we'll go into RasPlex. And there we have it. And done. So now we have Raspberry Plex, OpenELEC, Kodi, and Retropie all on one Raspberry Pi. Awesome.
Well, for those who like a little bit of choice when it comes to their Raspberry Pi, I highly recommend the quad boot image. So have you installed the quad boot image, or maybe you've had some trouble installing it yourself? Then leave me a comment down below. Well, that's it for another episode. I really hope you liked it. If you did, make sure you give me a big thumbs up or even leave me a comment down below. If you do enjoy the content that I'm providing here, then make sure you subscribe to my channel because it really helps me a lot. And as always, imagine, learn, create.